Dear students, today we will discuss about low frequency harmonic. So distributed generation, it does not produce completely sinusoidal current waveform, just like other equipments. Other equipment, they produce completely sinusoidal, but whereas distributed generation will not produce any completely sinusoidal waveform. So the harmonics injected into this distribution grid, that is by the generator, which result in the increase in the voltage distortion, right? So the emission by distributed generation, however it will be very small than the emission by modern consuming equipment. So the increase in voltage distortion, that will be small and rarely cause a problem. So this is especially be the case for those frequency components that have traditionally been dominating in the power system. So harmonics 5th, 7th, 11th, 13th, 17th, 19th and so on, as well as 3rd, 9th and 15th at low voltage. So the presence of distribution generation may however result in a significant increase in the level of frequency components that have traditionally been small. Even harmonics, that is higher order triplen harmonic and intra harmonic. The permissible levels for these frequency components have traditionally been low. So the hosting capacity that could actually turn out to be rather low. So the interaction between new equipment and the power line communication is however more complicated, and it depends upon the distortion level, right? So the harmonic emission of distributed generation is low for the frequency that have traditionally been concerned for harmonics, that is 3rd, 5th, 7th up to 1 kilohertz. A number of measurement examples have been discussed previously, right? So next is wind power, that is induction generator. So research has been already taken in induction generators. So as per the research, the measurements shown 30 kilowatt wind turbine together with a capacitor bank. So the current total harmonic distortion, that will be between 5% and 6%, with harmonics 5th, 11th and 13th being the dominant one. So the current distortion is measured between grid and the capacitor bank. So the main harmonics, that will be probably due to the capacitor bank only. So the harmonic voltage distortion, it was about 2.5% close to capacitor bank, with the fifth harmonic being very far the dominant component. Measurements of the harmonic emission of a 30 kilowatt wind turbine in a laboratory environment shows the total harmonic distortion between 1.5% and 4% for the current to the wind turbine. The harmonic distortion increases from 1.5% for zero wind up to 4% for wind speed around 12 meter per second. So generator with power electronic interface. 650 kilowatt unit connected to 6 kilovolt has been modeled in the simulation by using MATLAB. So by that we got some of the results. So harmonic voltage distortion, that is up to order 40 for hysteresis control, the highest distortion, that is 1.2%, occur for harmonic 40. A broadband emission is visible from order 20 upward. According to the measurement, wind turbine with power electronic converters shows a current distortion of 1.6% at 5th harmonic and 0.6% at 7th harmonic. All other harmonics are below 0.2%. Interharmonic, that is due to power electronic converter, are mainly due to frequencies which occur on the non-grid side of the converter. The coupling between two sides of a converter is strongest for cycloconverters, but even two converters connected via DC link will transfer frequency component. So resonances in a DC link may even amplify certain interharmonic frequencies. So we are consider six pulse input as well as output stage, which results in a spectrum with following frequency being presented. So next is synchronous generator. When using synchronous generator, their design should be such that they produce little third harmonic distortion. The low voltage system is almost a short circuit for triple harmonics, so which could cause a large third harmonic current with standard synchronous generator. The standard way of designing the winding of synchronous generator causes a large third harmonic voltage, about 10% of the fundamental component, whereas the fifth and seventh harmonic voltage, that will be around 1%. As the third harmonic component has zero sequence character, it is not transferred through delta connected generator transformer. However, when connecting a rotating machine directly to the low voltage network, that is without a transformer or through a star to star connected transformer, the third harmonic distortion that may spread through a system. So high penetration of such generator that may lead to excessive currents through neutral wire and delta winding in low and medium voltage network. So next is harmonic resonance. A potential problem with high penetration of distributed generation, this capacitance, it involves a series or parallel resonance which will cause amplification of harmonic distortion produced elsewhere. The increased capacitance is, however, not by the source of the harmonic distortion, and the harmonic currents which are generated by the unit that will be produced themselves or by the local equipment or by that equipment elsewhere. As the current generated by the unit does not significantly, it will be low frequency harmonic. The source is most likely found in other local equipment or in equipment elsewhere. So despite of this, the potential increase of voltage distortion should be treated as an impact of increasing the levels of distributed generation. Parallel and series resonance. A harmonic parallel resonance occurs when a harmonic current source sees the parallel connection of capacitance and an inductance. So okay, by the figure we can come to know that a generator is connected to a low voltage feeder with a capacitor close to the point of connection. So the generator, that could be an induction machine or a generator with power electronic interface, right? So any harmonic emission originating downstream of the point of connection will cease the parallel connection of the capacitor and the inductive part of the source impedance. The harmonic voltage at the point of connection, that will be equal to the product of harmonic current and the impedance at the harmonic frequency. So this impedance as a maximum at the resonance frequency If this resonance frequency corresponds to a frequency that is presented in the emission, high harmonic levels that may can occur. So a series resonance, you can see the series resonance diagram, which occur when the local capacitance is in resonance with the inductance between local bus and the remote bus, that is with a high harmonic voltage distortion. So with the result of this series resonance, the harmonic voltage distortion at the local bus could be very high. So the distributed generation is connected via generator transformer to a medium voltage feeder, and a capacitor is located close to the point of connection to compensate for the reactive power consumed by the generator. The harmonic voltage at the remote bus with distorted voltage indicated in the figure that may be amplified by the series resonance. And the capacitor involved in this series resonant is the capacitor at the point of connection. Cables and lines that will be the neighborhood also add the capacitance to the circuit. But at distribution levels, fixed capacitance banks that will be dominating. The inductance involved in the series resonance is the inductance between the point of connection and the bus with the distorted voltage. So at medium voltage level, for location not far away from the main medium voltage bus,